Janet Blackburn knows firsthand the harrowing effects of domestic violence. It claimed her sister 6 years ago.
Around 9:20 p.m., the lifeless bodies of Gail Pumphrey, age 43, and her children, David, age 12, Megan, age 10, and Brandon, age 7, were found.
Humphrey's ex-husband murdered her and their children before killing himself on Thanksgiving 2007 in Montgomery County.
He used her love for her children to get his way.
Maryland's efforts to combat domestic violence are being used as a model for the rest of the country. Deaths from domestic violence in Maryland dropped from 2006 to 2010 when an assessment program to identify victims and monitor offenders was implemented.
But we know that one death is one too many. We need to do a better job.
Vice President Joe Biden joined with the Department of Justice and Maryland officials to announce the awarding of more than $2 million in grants to implement similar programs in 12 communities across the country. Biden says the problem strikes home.
These aren't statistics. These are our mothers, our sisters, our daughters.
The vice president says more can be done to reduce the number of homicides from domestic violence, specifically with gun control.
A recent study shows the number of women shot to death by an intimate partner is 38% lower in states that require background checks for handguns.
But that's work still to be done. For now, for families who faced this type of tragedy, the pain remains.
I mean, that's all you can do. You have to go on, but you learn to live with it.
In Rockville, Haley Buhl, CNS TV.